Ladies and gentlemen, are we ready for the big, big main event of the evening? This is going to be an absolute beauty. Four Muay Thai rules, 5 by 3 minute rounds, and it is going to be a cracking main event. This fight is proudly sponsored by Easy Contractors, great sponsor, huge, huge company that always looks after power play. Okay, our first fighter, fighting out of the blue corner, comes all the way from Auckland, New Zealand, out of City Liga Gym, trained by Daniel Hatch and Philip Lamb. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Brad Riddell.
Here we go, guys. Do not underestimate Brad Riddell. 33 fights, 30 wins. He got the call a couple of days ago. He's based in Thailand now, formerly out of New Zealand. This man knocked out Aaron Goodson on a brute force show probably 18 months ago, Johnny Camp. And we weren't aware of what Brad Riddell was back then, and he absolutely schooled Aaron Goodson. He's ripped, he's ready to go. We've got Joe Hopkins and Richie Hardcore in the corner. As I said, flew in from Thailand on a
and his opponent in this main event of the evening, one of Australia's fan favourites, fought many times on the power play card. Trains out of Boon Chu Gym under Adrian Ormrod. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome JWP, John Wayne Parr!
There you go, guys. What everyone's got to
say. One more big round of applause for John Wayne Ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is the main event of the evening, Power Play 22 here at the Melbourne Pavilion in Flemington. Once again, sponsored by Easy Contractors, this is our main event, 5 by 3 minute rounds, full Muay Thai rules. Once again, let's welcome from the blue corner, all the way from New Zealand, Brad Riddell. He is taking on one of Australia's favourite, fighting out of the red corner, John Wayne Parr. Can I please have our music? Wai Kru Ramoi.
Guys, as we said, a last minute call up was Brad Riddell, all the way over from Thailand. John Wayne Parr was putting the WKA world title up for grabs against Cosmo Alexander. They'd fought twice before. It was one all. It was going to be the decider, but unfortunately, I think Cosmo just left it a little bit too late and didn't get his visa organised, which left Joe Nader with the unenviable position where he had to try and find a replacement to fight against John Wayne Parr. And I tell you what,
which is not easy to do.
Mate, it's not an opponent of a John Wayne Parr with 24 hours.
It's not easy at the best of times, but as you said, so full credit to Joe Nader. Yeah. He pulled out all stops, having a chat to him.
And John Wayne really is so grateful because all that preparation, and he almost never had a fight to come to here, guys, tonight.
And of course, as I said, Brad Riddell, 33 fights, 30 wins. He won the 2012 WMC eight-man eliminator over in New Zealand. He also made world news when he defeated a Chinese monk, Yi Long. Went back and then had a fight with him again in China and lost the rematch. But Philip Lam puts on some great promotions over in New Zealand, and Brad Riddell took on the Chinese monk, which you don't see too often.
Well, I can't recall anybody fighting a monk in under Muay Thai rules, but it's on his fight record here, so I'll give him credit for that.
This is the main event of the evening.
Yep, let's not forget, gentlemen.
Can I please have fighters to centering? 5x3 minute round.
Fighter with referee Ignatius Nicolini to lose and everything
okay, guys,
to gain.
I spoke about the rules in the change room.
If nobody knew who Brad Riddell was, they certainly do now.
Watch gloves now and good luck.
Five.
Well, and if he has
ladies and gentlemen, Brad Riddell taking on John Wayne Parr.
But he looks like a guy that looks like he's ready to fight John Wayne Parr. Let me tell you, looking at his body, his physique, his legs, he looks like a thoroughbred of that weight class, you know?
Jeez, he's got these legs remind me of your stand.
That's why I'm bringing them up, fellas. I'm looking at him and I'm saying I like his legs.
I was talking to Joe Hopkins out the back, and Brad was scheduled to fight in Macau next week, but that fight got pulled. So when he got the phone call, it was, yep.
Yeah.
Book me a seat on the next
round one.
So for the viewers at home, we all know John Wayne Parr in the black trunks, Brad Riddell. Do not underestimate this boy from New Zealand, now based out of Thailand.
So 5x3 minute rounds, full Thai rules, all the good stuff.
And a big thanks to Easy Contractors, building and maintenance company, getting behind this one. Main event sponsor of Power Play 22, Joe Nader. Once again, the Melbourne Pavilion, full to the brim, and another quality card. Said, let's not forget Brad Riddell came over from New Zealand, took on Aaron Goodson. We didn't know a lot about him, and he schooled Aaron Goodson with his hands and knocked him out.
So we're talking about
a switch up left.
Yeah, he looks like he rocked Wayne.
He is rocked. John Wayne Parr has been rocked by Brad Riddell in his first round.
With that switch up left roundhouse kick followed up by left hook.
Adrian Ormod and a crew dip over in the corner of John Wayne Parr.
Straight right hand to the body from Wayne, but
you know, you guys mentioned I didn't see the fight with Aaron and Riddell, but you say to me he schooled Aaron Goodson when it came to the boxing, and are we saying that he's got great hands, this kid?
Mate, he's just strong. He's fast. He has some good hands, but we've already seen his switch up left kick as well as already worried John Wayne Parr.
One of Wayne's strengths has been, for a long, long time, his boxing skills. Let's not forget, he did have a successful boxing career as well.
Oh!
He's put another short left hook flush on the chin of Wayne. He's rocked again here in the first.
John's trying to trade with him.
Yeah, trying to fight back now, but...
Nice elbow!
Good elbow.
This is where Riddell's got to be careful because he's hurt Wayne. Oh, they're going toe-to-toe, fellas.
Yeah, I'll look at Wayne absolutely trying to unload, but he's been hurt.
Oh, I'll tell you what, Brad Riddell, I think, is a little bit wobbled as well.
They're both wobbled.
Peter Lewis over there almost, we could stick some headphones on him. He's commentating as well. I tell you what, this is an unexpected first round. No one expected to see Brad Riddell wobble John Wayne Parr as he has. But credit to John Wayne Parr. This is why he's a 10-time world champion.
I tell you.
He's composed and he's got it back again.
And his defense after getting wobbled was come back and trade with him. You know, that was amazing.
Yeah, he absolutely let go a flurry of punches.
And Brad Riddell just looking super composed here in center ring though. But twice, John Wayne Parr's been caught with a left from Brad Riddell.
He has, and he's got almost like a crease on his face. You see a little bit of blood on the lip there, I'm not sure. But
geez, he'd want to plant that right hand as hard as he could against his chin or his cheek to defend against that.
Round one.
Brad
great round, great first round.
What an unbelievable shot to our main event of the evening.
On the 10-time world champion has rocked John Wayne Parr twice, but full credit to the gunslinger, he came back as well.
Yeah, absolutely. No one would have predicted this, but Brad Riddell's caused a huge upset here already. in the first round by rocking John Wayne Parr.
Stan, but as you said, the defence of John Wayne Parr was to get on the attack with his hands.
Yeah, unbelievable. He got tagged, fellas. He got tagged. He looked uncomfortable. But it's amazing to see him come back and rally with Riddell. It's amazing when normally a smart fighter, experienced fighter, you get caught, you're going to hold, you're going to... It's ring generalship, yeah? But to come back almost with pride to say, you're not going to hurt me and get away with it. It's unbelievable.
I tell you what, an absolutely amazing first round. Easy contractors, you're getting your money's worth for this main event. And as we said, mate, full credit to Joe Nader. He literally searched the world and came up with Brad Riddell, a New Zealand-based fighter. Went and based himself in China, now in Thailand. And I tell you what a first round we've had.
Well, absolutely. A huge upset here. Let's see.
I mean, just that first round has left most people in this audience holding their breath right now.
But one thing we know about the resolve of John Wayne Parr, he's not a 10-time world champion for no reason. He has fought the best of the best in his weight division around the world. He's fought all around the world. He's fought down here as well. But Brad Riddell, 33 fights, a third of the fights of John Wayne Parr.
How old's Riddell?
Not sure how old Brad is, mate, but I'll tell you what, he's only had the 33 fights, but he's had 30 wins in those 33 fights.
A big slapping round kick from Wayne Parr to open up the second round. Attempted catch and sweep. Brad manages to stay on his feet. Sticks the jab into Wayne Parr.
Yeah, the trademark switch up left of John Wayne Parr. Tell you what, the guard of Brad Riddell is super tight as well.
And it needs to be.
Oh, nice uppercut from the gunslinger.
Peter Hatton helping out in the corner with Richie Hardcore and Joe Hopkins. Talking to Joe Hopkins out the back, and he said Brad's last six fights he's won by KO overseas. So he's really racking up some big solid wins. But there's one thing though, John Wayne Parr's not going to drop his right hand again and get caught with that left hook again from Brad Riddell.
Well, that's the worst thing he can do, but I'm impressed with the Kiwi. He's not wasting any shots whatsoever.
Yeah, he's picking shots. He's not, you know, you're right, John, he's not wasting any shots. He's picking his shots. Look, we know Wayne Parr's an experienced campaigner, but we could be looking at something of the future here. I mean, you know, it kind of reminds me of me fighting Alexio and, you know, the Prince versus the King here right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah, very much so, Stan.
Mate, Riddell is not daunted by the man that he's facing
he's
here
not.
In centering.
Absolutely not. And he's got a plan. He's staying on the plan. Despite the fact the early success in the first round, he's got a game plan, and I like that.
Yeah, just a couple of knees thrown by each fighter in that clinch. Not a lot of mustard behind them.
See what the powerhouse event and function centre here in Flemington, Victoria, is absolutely full to the brim, and we're seeing it.
Well, there was a stunned silence there in that first round. Now a little bit more vocal from the crowd.
Yeah, mate. As I said, a lot of people they wouldn't have known anything about Brad Riddell, and everyone was coming along to see John Wayne Parr, and Brad Riddell silenced the crowd here in that first round.
1 minute into that first round, the crowd knew that this kid's bringing something here.
Yeah, crossing elbow there from Wayne Parr, taken on the gloves by Brad Riddell.
Of course, big shout out too to Angie Parr up there in Queensland. And of course, getting behind the Australian Muay Thai Awards coming up in December. Up on the Gold Coast Convention Centre. Jupiter's Casino. But I tell you what, two down, three to go. Right, this has been a sensational main event so far, guys.
Yeah, absolutely. Wayne Parr seems to have recovered from that first round. I won't call it a knockdown, but really... A couple of big shots from Riddell, but fairly even second round on my scorecard. Perhaps just slightly the way of Wayne Parr. Just a little bit busier. But as I said earlier on, Brad Riddell really being calculated, picking his shots, not wasting any energy whatsoever. Will he explode in the third?
Well, we know one thing with John Wayne Parr, he'll always step up the pace as well, but what's the game plan of Brad Riddell?
But you've got to remember, I'm not being pessimistic or anything like that. We know how John fights, but we've got to understand he's getting older too. He's getting older. We're looking at a young guy here. You know, he could potentially finish this fight strong. Really, there's always going to be a question mark when we look at Wayne Parr because we remember how great he was. And sadly, we don't want it to come to an end one day, but this kid might be saying, it's my time tonight. And that's what we're going to witness right now in the next three rounds.
You're quite right, Stan. It may yet all come down to the hunger.
Really. You know, I'm looking at a couple of little episodes there in that last round, and some of the combinations of Wayne Parr, they don't look as crisp as we remember him once. You know, and that's the definition of a fighter that he's at the twilight of his career. I mean, we know he retired, but he's young, and he came back. And the last thing you want to see is legends of our sport when we start noticing big changes in their styles. But look, it's going to be interesting to see because, look, experience is definitely on his side. But we've got a guy here that knows he is in a position to take the crown from the king.
Here we go, round three, proudly brought to you by Easy Contractors.
So you're watching the main event of Power Play number 22. The gunslinger John Wayne Parr in the black trunks.
Nice
Brad
left
Riddell
there.
In the red and silver.
Nice left from John Wayne Parr.
Okay, these guys are going to pick up the pace here, you guys. You have to say, you agree with me.
Mate, I think already you can see the tempo has lifted.
You can see the tempo has changed.
Oh, there's that left hand once again from Riddell.
And again, guys, we've got a big shout out to Joe Nader and the team at Power Play Promotions. As he said on Facebook, he could have let this fight go. He could have just said, oh, we'll just, you know, cancel the card. But too much time and money have been invested. And he's got a lot of respect for John Wayne Parr. And he knew what he'd been putting himself through with all the training. So he did what any great promoter would do. Yeah. And he found a quality opponent to replace Cosmo Alexander.
Yeah.
A little bit of the slip there from Wayne. Good defensive work from Brad Riddell.
Yeah, and that slapping rib kick there from John Wayne Parr. It's his trademark, the switch up left kick. Judges for this one, Shane Byrne, Bryce Burt Whistle and Mark Cook. Brad Riddell hasn't changed the expression throughout the whole fight. He's just looking super composed.
Once again, we see Wayne put together those five or six punch combinations that he is renowned for.
Almost looked like a bit of a head clash there as they were coming in for the grapple.
Nice front kick from Wayne. Put some boxing skills to use once again.
It's give and take, you know, at the moment. Both guys working, a good pace, both guys exchanging, but no one really taking an advantage of anything or clearly to say that he's winning the round. That's pretty even, both guys exchanging.
Probably Wayne Parr just the busier of the two by putting together his combos. Nice catch and sweep. Manages to take Brad Riddell to the canvas.
Now it's interesting, this one's under full tie rules. We haven't seen a lot of grappling. We saw Wayne Parr in the first round come back with some elbows, but we haven't seen a lot since from either boy. Happy to fight at the range. John Wayne Parr raising his hand to say, I've won that third round.
Yeah, and I think that he did on my scorecard. We're just a little bit busier than Brad Riddell, but Wayne Parr raises his hand confidently at the end of that third round.
Dan, I'll tell you what, it's a main event. It's an epic main event so far, as we said. We've said it before, and I'll say it again. Brad Riddell, unexpected, not a lot of people knew it. But I tell you what, John Wayne Parr, he's got his work cut out for him.
Well, after the first minute, you know, we were shocked. I was actually shocked. But I've got to be honest with you, although Riddell's there with him, I haven't seen anything really since that first minute that kind of scared me with anything. They're fighting, they're doing well, it's pretty even. You know, John might have won that last round, but other than that early exchange where he caught John Wayne Parr, cold, a little bit of shock in all of us, but really John Wayne Parr has nullified everything since then. And that's the experience that we're talking about.
If it comes down to winning this fight on points, we know that Wayne, with 116 fights under his belt, he will make sure that he does enough to rack up enough points
to win
this fight.
That's the key factor, in my opinion, about this fight, is that his experience, ring generalship, all that has got to come into the factor of the fight. We're looking at a young guy here. You know what I mean? There's a lot for him. He sees a lot when he looks at John Wayne Parr. He knows he's fighting a campaigner like that. But he's got to do something to pull like a rabbit out of the hat. You can't continue the contest of that last round because you'll get beat on points. If he's happy to go five rounds and lose on points, then he's going the right way about it. But to beat John Wayne Parr today, he's going to have to do more than what he did in the last round.
Expect to see John Wayne Parr step up the tempo now with his hands and see if he can start rattling Brad Riddell.
That's when we're going to see if Riddell can rally with him, Burgess.
See, two-punch kick combination from Wayne.
Yeah. This is the round that we're going to find out what Riddell's about, fellas. This round.
So we're at round number four, the penultimate round. Once again.
And I'll tell you what, both boys know what's on the line here.
Flurries of punches again from Wayne. Punch-kick combo. Another punch-kick combo. Raz, look at Riddell. Single kick, single punch.
Yeah, John Wayne Parr really stepping it up now in this fourth round. The championship round stand, as they call it.
Yep.
Oh, good jabs from Wayne to set up the right hand.
Peter Hatton just calling out for Brad Riddell to come forward.
Nice straight right hand there by John Wayne. Nice combinations again. Nice check.
Crossing elbow from John Wayne Parr, just missed the mark.
Oh, step up elbow from the gunslinger. Interesting how both fighters not really interested in clinching or knees at all so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for Brad Riddell.
Oh. Both boys exchanged beautiful lifts, and they both got caught simultaneously.
Now Wayne applies the clinch, drives two knees into the right rib cage of Brad Riddell.
One of the techniques we see John Wayne Parr use a lot is the teep, and we haven't seen a lot of it tonight. That front push kick just to keep his opponent at range.
Step up elbow from Wayne. Oh, now tries the spinning elbow.
And Brad Riddell not looking fazed at all by the gunslinger in front of him.
Yeah, but he's got to do more. If he's going to be effective, he's got to do more.
Absolutely. He
John Wayne's in control right now.
Yeah, this fourth round is all John Wayne Parr at the moment.
Yeah.
Brad Riddell continues to push forward, but just not busy enough.
He's going to have to take some risks. He's going to have to take... At the way it's looking at the moment, as he lands the left.
Wayne looks like he's being wobbled once again with that left.
Was the overhand right that set up the left? So he's hurt Wayne Parr. But
this is what he's got to do. He's got to go toe-to-toe with John Wayne here.
Yeah, Wayne's fighting back once again.
Crossing elbow from Riddell, not quite close enough. Right on the bell again. Brad Riddell just turns it up in those last 15 seconds. We've got four rounds down, one to go. That was John Wayne Parr's round, but I tell you what, Brad Riddell's here for a fight.
In the last 10 seconds, he just pulled it out of nowhere.
And the New Zealander.
don't know. It's just look,
I really believe, in my opinion, that John Wayne Parr is in control of his fight. He's winning the fight, but there's a couple of little moments there of complacency where he's gotten tagged and the lights kind of, you know, shook up a little bit.
Riddell let it go with the overhand right. He tagged him and set up the left hand. And it looked like he hurt Wayne Parr again there in the final seconds of that fourth round.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see the strategy now of John Wayne Parr. Does he come out and try and finish Brad Riddell? Or does he stand back and just, Riddell's going to step it up. There's no doubt about that. So do they stand there and trade?
Well, if Riddell comes in stepping it up, you've got to imagine that John Wayne Parr's ahead on points and he'll use the experience to get through the round and not worry about losing the round, you know what I mean? If pride kicks in, and he wants to finish strong, sometimes that could be a good thing, but it could also backfire, you know?
But yeah, as we said in the first round, his best form of defense was attack after he got rocked.
Absolutely.
So expect Brad Riddell to come out. He's going to throw absolutely
He's going to have to. I mean, if he came in just to fill the numbers, to make the show continue, we'll know about it. But if he comes out in this round, because he knows he wants to do something.
Richie Hardcore absolutely in the face of Brad Riddell, winding him up. You've got Joe Hopkins and Peter Hatton in the corner as well. Here we go, the fifth and final round. Power play number 28. Proudly brought to you by Easy Contractors. Great respect from both boys in centre ring, guys. 3 minutes to go.
Yeah, the final round of Power Play 22. We're coming to you live from the Melbourne Pavilion.
And you're watching this on Epicentre Live. Brad Riddell stepping it up. John Wayne Parr, good counter fighting.
And once again, Wayne very busy with his hands. Finishes off with the low kick.
Peter Hatton calling out for Brad Riddell to use the left hook.
Nice high kick there by John Wayne. Nice front kick. They're going toe-to-toe here.
Yeah, absolutely. And they're exchanging left and right punches, both fighters. Although Wayne backs off and then moves forward again. Tries the uppercut.
Ignatius missile.
Yeah, very slippery here. Surface there with a...
Bit of house cleaning there in centre ring. Peter Hatton just asking Brad Riddell just to use his hands nice and straight. Resuming back in centre ring.
Crowd now absolutely going crazy here at the Melbourne Pavilion. Oh, beautiful, great left hand.
This is the experience of the gunslinger starting to come to the fore now, Stan.
Clinical catch and sweep. That's Wayne just racking up some extra points.
A sneaky little elbow there by John Wayne.
So one thing with the guard of Brad Riddell, he keeps it nice and tight. That's what the crowd's come to see. Both boys standing there trading. Big hands from John Wayne Parr.
Once again, those punch combinations from the gunslinger. Puts Brad Riddell on the back foot. Let's go, step up knee. There's the teep you're asking for, Johnny.
Mate, I'm surprised John Wayne Parr hasn't used them more as Brad Riddell continually walks forward. But I tell you what, at the moment, John Wayne Parr, he's retaining this fight, mate. He's doing a great job. He's just got to keep his hands up nice and high.
Jumping knee from the gunslinger. He's really now putting on a show here in the final stages of this fifth round.
Spinning back elbow from John Wayne Parr, caught on the gloves, Brad Riddell. I think Brad Riddell's just hoping to get that left hook in nice and close. That seems to be what he's waiting for.
He's very experienced. John Wayne Parr's fighting very smart here. He's doing enough to not only win the round, but be in control.
There's that front
Almost
kick
Almost telling
again.
This kid that you ain't got what you need to beat me just yet.
Yeah, absolutely, and there you go. Puts him once again on the canvas. Riddell quickly back on his feet.
It reminds me a bit of Jarba Askarov as Brad Riddell in the physique and the way he just walks forward. And his nose looks a little bit like Jarba Askarov.
Oh, look at those three elbows in succession from
hey,
the gunslinger.
John's finishing. John Wayne Parr's finishing stronger than Riddell.
10 seconds.
Body rips. Step up elbow. Nice. Spinning back kick. And oh, well, there you go. What a great finish from Wayne Parr.
Absolutely sensational main event here. Yeah. Full credit to Brad Riddell for stepping up at the last minute. But the gunslinger John Wayne Parr should take it. And great respect from Brad Riddell. Absolutely great respect. And what a moment it is for Brad Riddell with 33 fights to get the call up to fight the 10-time world champion John Wayne Parr.
A lot of respect out of the corner there from John Wayne Parr. For Riddell, Brad Riddell, he can walk with his head up high, he's got nothing to be ashamed about.
Be very proud of yourself, young man.
Absolutely sensational main event.
A name that will not be easily forgotten, Brad Riddell. He stepped up, he took the challenge. He took the 10-time world champion to the distance. He actually rocked Wayne Parr in the first round.
I'll tell you what, guys, that has been an absolutely epic main event. Joe Nader and Powerplay Promotions. It's been sensational, it really has.
Yeah, look, we've had a great night of fights. We've had pretty much everything. We've had knockouts, we've had cuts.
And I'll tell you what, John Wayne Parr, mate, he's earned his paycheck here tonight. He would have been disappointed when he got the phone call to say that Cosmo Alexander wasn't making it over after all that. But I tell you what, a more worthy opponent could not have been found than Brad Riddell on such short notice.
You couldn't find a more worthy opponent.
Brad Riddell and John Wayne Parr. Fighters to center ring.
Here we go, waiting for the decision. A big thanks to the Easy Contractors.
This fight went all the distance, 5 rounds. Judge won 50-46, 50-45, and 50-45. A unanimous decision winner, red corner, John Wayne Parr.
A unanimous points decision victory to the gunslinger, John Wayne
Unbelievable
Parr.
Win.
I probably would have given Before one round at least fighters, the first to
I would like
Brad Riddell.
Joe Nader, our power play owner and director, to say he was unbelievable fight, Joe.
Took the challenge. Thank he took Wayne Parr the distance. He's a name now that will be remembered in Melbourne.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say a couple of things, and I really need to express these words. Brad took this fight on a 48-hour notice. He is the underdog. Give him a round of applause, guys.
A standing ovation from the crowd for Brad Riddell.
Ladies and gentlemen, just one other thing. Tonight's fight, unfortunately, was meant to be for a world title against Cosmo Alexander. Due to a visa problem, we couldn't make that happen. So that Brad did jump in at a last-minute replacement. I think tonight, Brad owned the respect and the opportunity after I speak to Mr. Michael Kenner to challenge Wayne for his world title and our next event next year. So if you ever want to see that, guys, get behind these two guys and let's make it happen for a world title because it is well deserved. Thank you very much.
We have a rematch for the world title. John, stay there. I'll interview first. On 4 days' notice, unbelievable scenes. Obviously, Cosmo Alexander pulled out. 22 years old, from New Zealand. Brad, an unbelievable experience just to fight the great John Wayne Parr, let alone just produce an unbelievable fight of the year.
It was just awesome to actually meet John Wayne Parr, let alone fight him. He was legitimately the reason I started Muay Thai, so... It's awesome.
How's it feel fighting one of your idols, mate? It must be a great feeling. No doubt you'll have a few drinks at the after party together. How were the nerves, short notice, and to fight a legend in Australia sport at such a young age?
I was really nervous. It gets a little bit better when I got...